booming economy in the United States. He's taken complete credit for that. And you say, when you look at the numbers, it's actually the opposite.
Well, he has a very poor economic record overall once we get to the end of his term. Now, obviously, there are two different phases of his term. There's the first 3 years, and there's this year. In the first 3 years, he was constantly lying and saying, I've created the greatest economy in the world. That was false. He inherited trends of recovery from the Obama administration. And again, presidents don't create the economy. Presidents can influence it somewhat and have some effect on it. But the economy moves according to its own rhythms. President Obama took some actions to get us out of the Great Recession. Those had some beneficial effects. The economy has been in a long recovery. Trump continued that. Unemployment rate going down, not because of what Donald Trump did, but because that was the trend in the economy. The two big things that Donald Trump did economically, tax cuts, had very little lasting effect on the economy, brief short-term boost, and the China trade war harmed the economy. That's why he called it off before his re-election year. Then when you get to 2020, you had the pandemic, which of course devastated economic activity, and what a president can do in that situation is respond to it and try to mitigate and control and ameliorate the problem. The president's response to the coronavirus was bungled. That means that we had an extended and continuing still to this moment terrible setback for the economy. We expect in December, because the Trump administration has failed to control the coronavirus, they politicized it, they ensured that we had a muddled, disorganized response on testing, on masks, on all sorts of things. We expect that in December, the economy will shed jobs, stop recovering, but actually shed jobs. And in the first quarter of 2021, as Joe Biden takes over, J.P. Morgan says that Donald Trump is going to hand Joe Biden a shrinking economy. That is a bad record. If you look overall, the 13 presidents since World War II, Trump will have presided, because the economy is going to shrink by a substantial amount this year. Donald Trump will have presided over the smallest economic growth of any of those 13 presidents, and he's the only one of them who will leave office with fewer people employed than the day he went into office.
One thing that could mitigate that is if Congress gets something done this week with some kind of relief bill. We are waiting to see if there's any progress there. John Harwood, thank you very much. Natasha Alford, great to see you as well. Thanks for being with us. What does it take to distribute and vaccinate millions of people, maybe in a matter of days? Closer look at one city's plan